Is the era of working virtually from home finally upon us? Because if Twitter is closing its office doors worldwide, and other tech giants like Google, Amazon, and Facebook are extending office closures until as late as the fall of 2020 or even into 2021, how many other tech companies will follow in the steps of their industry leaders? In other sectors like insurance and finance, we've heard Nationwide Insurance is talking about permanent telecommuting. Capital One has announced to their workers, all 40,000 of them, they will remain out of the office at least through Labor Day. Regardless of how you feel about an industry giants or the belief that they already have tons of advantages, like plenty of hardware and software at their disposal or enough revenue and reserves to properly outfit their employees, we can't deny that these companies could be forging the future of business that extends beyond pandemic and social distancing times. This path could be advantageous to a great number of employers and businesses, regardless of size. There are a ridiculous number of benefits to working from home for both employer and employee, or business owner and contractor. And I should know, I've been running a business from my home since 2001, and training expert VAs and virtual experts how to do the same since 2008. The success is in part because of the advantages we have of working from home. Benefit number one of working from home: reduced overhead costs and increased business investments. As a virtual business owner, I know firsthand the cost savings from low overhead. I don't have a commercial lease, utility bills, supply vendor contracts, or other monthly expenses associated with keeping an office space open. And I certainly couldn't imagine the expense I would incur now if I did and had to go about remedying the air filtration, the interior design office space for distancing requirements, the supply of thermometers, gloves, and masks. The money that isn't spent on these overhead items can now be invested in other areas of my business, like any number of revenue generating initiatives that fall under product or service research and development, sales, marketing, or into bringing on more team members, more experts in their area to manage parts of my business that I'd rather stay out of so I can stay focused where my attention is needed. Benefit number two of working from home: employee and contractor satisfaction and performance. I believe the working virtually from home model works because of the independence and autonomy it gives to employees and contractors. In my business, I work with contractors. They have the freedom to complete their tasks without my interference by looking over their shoulders. They have my trust that they'll do it well and do it right. I'm not suggesting that businesses that employ people suddenly stop supervising altogether. I'm suggesting that the freedom and autonomy that can come from working from home might lend itself to greater employee satisfaction. Additionally, for business owners with employees, the overhead costs incurred in physical building expenses and management could be filtered over to meeting employee needs. Think better benefits, perhaps, or in establishing comfortable at-work home conditions like ergonomic setups. These things could support greater employee satisfaction and performance. There have already been studies on the benefits of remote working at the employee level, things like happiness, work-life balance, better productivity, reduced stress. And this was before COVID-19, before health and safety were at the top of everyone's mind. Employers may be fearful that people working from home are getting less done because they are taking more breaks or throwing too many loads of laundry in. But consider that those people who take more frequent breaks actually end up being more productive, or the fact that throwing in a load of laundry can take as much time as going to the bathroom and then returning to your desk in an office setting. Those mental breaks and getting up to move is good for both the body and the mind and the overall performance of the employee. And the better your employees, the better your business, right? Benefit number three of working from home, health and safety for us and the planet. Last but certainly not least, the health and safety of our workforce as well as our planet is better off when we work from home. With access to their own kitchens, our workforce may actually eat and snack in healthier ways. With access to their home gym or workout equipment, our neighborhood for running and walking, and no commuting time, they may actually have time to fit in exercise during their lunch break or get to it right before or after work in place of the time spent in their car. While at home, they don't have to worry as much about getting something from their colleagues who just didn't call in sick when they should have. Let's face it, even before COVID-19, people were showing up to the office with sniffles, sore throats, chills, and any number of symptoms that should have kept them home. And then they would be touching all kinds of shared surfaces throughout the day without proper hand washing. From the planet perspective, just imagine how much cleaner our air and healthier our environment will be with fewer people driving every day, fewer buildings throwing all the lights and power on, less paper being used, less waste in general. I know this may be oversimplification and not counting in winter months or summer months where we crank up the AC, but I'm willing to bet there are already people looking at how these changes to our work-home life in light of COVID-19 have impacted our environment and what that means for our future. If you're worried about those buildings that are now sitting idle and taking up space in our cities and towns without any occupation, there are solutions for those too. There are plenty of brilliant humans to figure out ways to repurpose those beautiful buildings and skyscrapers. I know it's a lot to consider. Shutting down physical office locations, keeping colleagues separated, letting go of the way we used to do business. I recognize that not every industry, not every sector has the ability to go remote. Our food and beverage, hospitality, travel, and tourism industries aren't going to be able to go 100% virtual. People want to resume eating out, going for drinks, traveling. Despite that, many of us can work from home. Businesses can grasp the advantages of working remotely. Twitter, Google, Facebook, Amazon are always on the cutting edge of technology. Why shouldn't they also be on the cutting edge of the future of business? The question is, will you follow them into the future or hold on to the past? If you'd like to learn more about what it's really like to work from home as a virtual assistant and virtual expert, please watch my free webinar by clicking the link below. And I'd love it if you would also subscribe to my YouTube channel and then click like on this video and comment below. Let me know what you think about working from home, working remotely as an employee or as an employer.